Hey, Steve Krivda here. Sorry, I'm going to make a little bit of room for myself here. So, time management is a real bugger sometimes, and I can tell you that was probably one of my biggest excuses for succeeding. And when I hear someone say, well, I just don't have the time, my response to that is, you know, it's not necessarily that you don't have the time, you don't have the desire, you don't have the wants. So let's take a quick look at this, okay? I have my trusty whiteboard and my erasable pen, and this is what we're gonna. I want to show you something here. All right. So the normal person works 8 hours a day. Okay. What you're supposed to get for sleep is 8 hours. Now, if you're like me, I usually get around six. So, we're actually taking away from the time that is being absorbed toward the day. So now we have, that's 16 hours. And then we have 8 hours to eat, to watch TV, to play with the kids, hang out with your spouse, and so on and so on and so on. Okay? So there's your 24 hours. Oh, and forgot, my favorite, the gym. Okay? So, there's your 24-hour day. That's not including weekends. If you work on the weekends, you probably have different days off. So, and this is only a 5-day work week. So here's something I want to show you. This is very interesting because I had to do this for myself. I wrote down, put these up here, and I'm going to circle the 8, okay? I wrote down, what do I do during the day? This is an exercise that I learned from a Robert Kiyosaki course that I took. I was up around 7 a.m., we'll say 7:30. No, 7 a.m. I get ready, I'm at work at around 7:35 is a good average. I'd work till around 1 p.m. And I'll put W in here. I go to the gym. We'll put a G. And then I was back to work until around 6 to 7 o'clock at night. And that was every day, Monday through Friday. And then on Saturdays and Sundays, I would be running around the house, helping my wife and playing with the kids. Okay? So there's my day. So basically, from 7 to 7, 12 hours a day, I was busy. Okay? So, what I did was I reevaluated on what I'm doing here. So, that was my time. So we had 7. This was pre-evaluation. So I decided I needed to make a decision here. Do I want to take the time to succeed in my life so in a couple of years I will have this complete 24 hours to do whatever I want, or do I continue running around in the rat race? And I said, just like in previous videos, TGIT, thank God it's today, because I made a decision and I made a choice and I took action. So what I did was, my 7 o'clock turned into 6. I got up at 6. Now, I'm at the gym at around, not too early. I'm at the gym around 6:45, and now I'm at work at around 7:55. So there's the gym. Now, my work ethic is a little bit different than most. Okay, when I have my lunch, I don't typically leave my desk, and I'm gonna tell you why. I like periodically throughout the day, if I come up with an idea, or if I have an email idea or a blog idea or anything like that, I'd like to take 5 minutes and I like to jot it down. So I probably do that. If I do that 10 times a day, that's 50 minutes. There's my lunch break. Okay, so now I'm at the office until around 5:30. Okay, now before it was 7, I was at the office at 7:45, and with the gym and work, I was at the office until about 7. Okay, you can see what I did here. I prioritized the important things in my life, okay? And this is not the important things. What I'm getting to is important, all right? So now, what do you do at 6 o'clock in the morning? You're sleeping. If you can't get up at 6 o'clock in the morning to do something important for yourself, then you need to go to bed earlier. You need to be in, if you're in bed at 11 o'clock, which is a little bit late on a weekday, I know this makes me sound kind of old, but it's not. I'm not old. I'm responsible. So if you're in bed at 11 and you're up at 6, that's 7 hours sleep, man. That is way more than the average person, and that's pretty darn good. All right, so anyways, so now I'm at home at 6:15, okay? And I spent about an hour prospecting. And blogging or whatever. Making contacts. Right in the middle here. Somewhere. Okay? Now, if you want to leave for an hour for lunch and go down to Starbucks or whatever and bring your laptop and do your thing at Starbucks, it doesn't really matter. Man, that light is really bright. It doesn't really matter because this time is your time. Okay? Everybody gets an hour for lunch. If you don't get an hour for lunch, well, you're probably going to have to talk to your boss about that. Okay? So now I'm home at 6:15 at the latest during the week. And that's kind of late. I try my best to get home a little bit earlier. Now, from 6:15 till around 8:45, I have time to hang out with my wife, my two little boys, eat dinner, run around, wrestle, whatever. Okay? Now you're saying, well, it doesn't seem like it's a lot of time, Steve, an hour during the day. Well, an hour during the day is a really long time. Especially when you're spacing it out, it doesn't seem like much, but when you think about an hour, put this into consideration. If it takes you 5 minutes to write a blog, but it reaches 50 people, and one person gives back to you and says, hey man, that sounds kind of cool. I'm interested in what you're saying. That person, in my primary business, when somebody comes into my company, I make a $100 commission. Well, if I worked an hour that day, I made $100 an hour. Okay? So I want you to keep that in mind. Okay? So, back to what we were saying. Now, we put the kids to bed, and now it's 9:15, and I sit down with my wife, Danielle. Okay, this is where this is quiet time for us. Okay, we usually hang out and talk about our day. Even though we work together, we still talk about our day. Now, I have drive and I have wants and I have needs because my needs are this. Those are my wants. My needs and my wants are the same thing. I want more time with my wife. I want more time with my kids. And I am tired and I love my boss because he is my father-in-law. I hate coming into work. I hate having to be somewhere 8 to 9 hours a day. I hate it. It drives me crazy. On the weekends when I wake up with my children because they typically wake me up. I play with them all day. I do a couple of hours of my network marketing. And the rest of the time is spent having a good time. Okay? Wouldn't it be cool to wake up on a Monday or a Tuesday and say, man, you know what? I think today I'm going to take the kids fishing. Or today, I'm going to go down to the beach with the boys. Or today, here's something cool. I'm going to spend the day with my wife and see if the in-laws will watch the boys. I'm going to go to the beach with my wife. Or you know, if you're a woman, a husband. So, anyways. So, about 9:15, I'm still in Steve Krivda mode. So, I sit in front of my laptop and I put about another hour into my network marketing. Now here's the cool thing. My wife, Danielle, is on board with me. So, Now, it's Steve and Danielle time here. Because we have fun. We don't consider network marketing a job. We consider it a good time. We have fun with it together. My primary business actually happens to deal with MS-70 silver gold, or MS-70 government mint gold and silver coins. We don't mind getting them every month. It's not like we have to hurry up and drink our juice by the end of the month, or use our soap, or change our filters out, or whatever. It doesn't really matter. We enjoy what we do, okay? This, accompanied by, I'm not going to get into the tax deductions. Even though tax deductions for having your own business is about $20 a day, you're throwing out the window. And if you go to stevekrivda.com, which I'll put at the end of this video, or at the bottom somewhere, if you go to stevekrivda.com and click on paying too much taxes, you'll see what I'm talking about there. That's a completely different issue. So, now you can see, where's my time here? From 6 to 10:15, I've got my gym. In fact, today's Wednesday, I don't go to the gym because of my day off. So I got to stroll into work at 7:30, I slept in. It's got the gym here, I work, I spend time with the family, spend an hour with my wife, working, and I'm being successful. There's no reason why you can't be successful. Because this time right here, this 2.5 hours here, could be this. Okay? And I'm not even saying spend 2.5 hours. I like to spend about 1 to 2 hours a day on my business. Alright? Network marketing, if somebody tells you, or if you're saying, I don't have time to do this, then your wants, your needs, and desires are completely off base. If you want a bigger TV, this won't work. If you want a pretty car, this won't work. If you want a bigger house, this will never work. If you want more time with your family, if you want more time with your kids, if you want more time with your wife, and that priority is wrong, it's wife and kids, you'll do what it takes to survive. Just wanting more things, it's not going to cut it, man. It's not going to cut it. You got to figure out your why, which is I covered in a previous blog. You need to figure out your why. If your why is having more time, you're on the right track. If you just want a couple more bucks, maybe you want to pay your electric bill. Maybe you want the burden of every Friday or every Monday starting from absolute zero. You come in every single Monday to work, and your check is this much. In network marketing, we have what we call residual income, where every day money is added to your check. Every single day. You don't start off from scratch every Monday. Okay? So, anyways, here we are. What I want you to do is go to Steve Krivda. That's an A. .com. Do you want your taxes back? Go to paying too much in taxes at the tab at the top. You'll see this blog on, it's called Time Management. Don't short yourself. This is not necessarily for me, man. This is for you. Don't short yourself with the excuse of I don't have time. Because it's an excuse. It's just an excuse. It's a reason to not do something. It's an excuse. Okay? Do yourself a favor. Be true to yourself. If you want something, go out there, and I want you to take it. Nobody else is going to do it for you. You are the only one that can take control of your own destiny. And if you can't sacrifice an hour or 2 hours a day, then your whys aren't big enough, because your other alternative is to get a part-time job. So now you're leaving your house, you're going to spend 45 minutes between getting ready and driving to the office. You're going to spend gas to get there, and that's just getting there. You're going to work your 3 or 4 hours a day, maybe on Saturdays and Sundays, and then you're going to spend another figure 20 to 30 minutes driving home. So now you're spending 6 hours for one day for 4 hours worth of work at what, $10 an hour, so $40 minus taxes. So now you're going to get what, 30, and it wasted 6 hours a day when you could sit at your house and you're on your computer working. I don't even consider it work, but working. And if your son comes in, my wife works with me, next to me on her laptop. If my son comes in and says, "Daddy, I had a bad dream," guess what I get to do, man? I get to take my laptop, put it to the side, and I get to go and comfort him, man. I get to take him back to bed and tuck him in. You have no idea how awesome that is to me. That's my part-time job. My part-time job is sitting at home, playing on the laptop, or drawing on a whiteboard. Okay? So, seriously, think about it. Think about your excuses and think about your whys. My whys are my wife and my boys. That's why I do what I do, and that's why I'm successful. All right, so that's it. I'm done. Here's my little stuff. Remember, stevekrivda.com, stevekrivda.com, and check out what I have to offer, and I think you're going to like it. Remember, man, if you want something, take it. That's it. See ya.